Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It is Drew here from Lone Fox. I hope you're having an amazing day, and I cannot believe it's a couple days until Christmas. That is absolutely insane, but I want to wish all of you guys a happy holiday for whatever you do celebrate. My hair is literally like poking my forehead and making it itch. First world problem. I'm also wearing my blue Lone Fox hoodie, which is super cute, but besides the point, today I'm doing a dollar store DIY video, which I am so excited for because I love doing videos like this. I actually posted over my community tab the other day and asked you guys what you wanted to see, and the number one vote was for a dollar store video. But I did go down in the comment section after going to the dollar store, and I came back home and I just wanted to like check the poll again. I looked at the comment section and there were a couple people expressing their concerns for this not being a sustainable practice and not being a sustainable video, and I just kind of wanted to put a tiny bit of input on that. The reason I do videos like this is because when I do videos where they are more sustainable, such as thrift flips or upcycling videos, the thing about those videos is that you guys cannot recreate the projects. There are not projects that you can go out and find the items for or the materials for because they're from a thrift store. Every thrift store kind of has very random items. So the thing about these dollar store videos is that a lot of the times I get pictures and photos from you guys that have recreated my projects all the time over on Instagram. And I create videos like this for people who are on a budget, like who really don't have the money to go out and spend hundreds of dollars at CBG or hundreds of dollars at Target. Like, these are great, inexpensive, beautiful decor items for people who don't have a budget that can go out to the dollar store and be like, oh, those are the items that Drew used in his video. I'm gonna pick those up and recreate that project for my room. So I hope that gives you guys kind of like an insight on why I do videos like this. I love doing sustainable videos, of course, and I'm trying to live a more sustainable lifestyle for sure, but I do want to incorporate videos like this every now and then. And also keep in mind, I only posted 2 dollar store videos all of 2019, so it's not a humongous like common occurring video for me. So now that I got that out of the way, I do want to also mention that I'm doing a humongous giveaway at the end of this video, just kind of like a happy holidays, merry Christmas, 2020, new year giveaway, and I'm so excited. So definitely stay tuned to the end because I'm giving away $500 in prizes, but let's get into today's video. Alrighty guys, so jumping into our first project, we are using this dollar napkin holder from the dollar store. I'm also going to be using some assorted yarns and really pretty colors, a hot glue gun, white spray paint, and scissors. So what we are creating is kind of like a decorative object. It really doesn't serve like a humongous like functional purpose, but it is super cute, very retro and quirky, and just like kind of adds a handmade touch to your space. So I started off by taking that napkin holder and giving it a coat of white spray paint. I love this Rust-Oleum like paint and primer. It just works really great. Once that was completely dry, what I'm doing next is I'm going to be cutting out small strips of yarn, and I'm basically going to be color blocking sections onto this to kind of create like a rainbow half circle just decor piece. I feel like this is definitely something you would go in like an artisan shop and you would just see it on the shelf. It would be like $64 and it would be made by like some lady and I don't know who has like 64 cats, you know, and she just loves making things, and you're like, oh my gosh, I want to buy this so badly, but it's $64. So we're just recreating it. So I started off with this really pretty kind of like rusty coral color. And a tip for you guys is once you reach the end, cut off your excess and then use a little bit of hot glue and the end of a paintbrush just to make sure everything is secured on the backside. Because once you have like your glue on the backside, no one's gonna see it. So feel free to add as much as you need. I'm then going in with this little cream color, and I'm also definitely like varying the weights of the yarn. That first one was a bit thicker than the cream one. And we are just basically creating color blocked sections. So this next yarn was one that kind of had a twisted color in there. I'm doing a darker orange rusty color here, and I'm kind of going for almost a retro, just like sunshiny, rusty coral tone. Like, there's no rhyme or reason to this. You can really go with whatever fits your personal style. I've just been loving this color palette lately, and like for quite a while, as you guys know on my channel, going with a darker color here, and you're just gonna continue this all the way through. And then once you reach the very end, you're going to add your last strand, glue it off, and that really finishes everything off. You can go on the backside, add a little bit more glue if needed. And then really guys, this is your finished off little quirky decorative object. This product is like the star of the show. I'm obsessed with it. I use a wreath form from the dollar store, some white spray paint, macrame rope, scissors, and a tweezer. And then I also got my inspo from this Urban Outfitters mirror. I loved it, but it was $99. And I was like, we could recreate this for under $10. So I'm starting off with the wreath form. I'm gonna give it a nice coat of that white spray paint. And I just wanted to do this because any areas that are peeking through, I just wanted it to blend in a little bit more than having it be black. So the next what I did was grabbed my macrame cord, and what I'm doing with this, and I'll link this exact spool from Amazon in the description box for you guys, is I am cutting 6-inch sections of rope, and you're literally just going to need to cut like 500 6-inch sections. Not really, well, you're just going to have to cut accordingly to your wreath size, but what I'm doing is I'm starting on the second innermost circle, and I'm going to be folding my rope pieces in half, pulling the ends through the loop, and I'm pretty sure all you guys know how to do this. It's like a very self-explanatory like knot. You're just going to pull them through on the second circle, and you're going to be doing this continuously all around the circle. And then once you reach like the end of a section, I went ahead and I unraveled each section, and then I pulled each piece apart. But I'll show you in a second like a little tip that I found out halfway through, which would have made life so much easier. But I manually unraveled every single rope and then manually like ripped them apart. The actual unraveling wasn't that hard, but the fraying part was a little bit more challenging. And once you get the section done, you can go through with a pair of scissors and just trim any excess pieces that are kind of like just random stray long sections, and you're just going to be repeating this process. So I continued cutting 6-inch sections of rope, looping them on. Here I'm about a quarter of the way done. I finished half of that second loop, but I'm going to be doing two layers. That's why I started on the second loop. You could actually do more than two if you wanted to, but I just felt like two was definitely enough. So then once you loop all those on, you're going to go through and fray them once again. This is just going to make it really full. And here's my little tip slash trick that I wanted to share with you is I grabbed tweezers, and this made the process of just like shredding kind of the rope sections so much easier, so much quicker. It was just very, very nice when I figured this out. You could probably also use a comb if you wanted to. The tweezers were just handy for me, so I just went through and really frayed all of it. This is gonna make it nice and fluffy and full for our first ring. So this is what we have so far, and we're gonna be doing the same exact thing on the innermost circle using the same exact length, the 6-inch sections, and that is because we want there to be kind of like a tiered layer. So I went through off camera, did all that. You're gonna flip the sections to the inside and then fray them with your tweezers once again. Flip them back, and then you're gonna repeat this section all the way around. So as you can see, using that same length, you're gonna have like maybe an inch of the back layer showing, which I think is very, very crucial, just so that it shows that there's two layers. It looks a little bit more full and just a lot more pretty. Once that is completely done, you can flip it over, and I grabbed this mirror actually at Joann's Fabrics. You can get it using a 40% off coupon, and it's like $4 with a coupon. I used my Gorilla Glue hot glue sticks, and I went around the edge, placed my mirror down, and then I flipped it over to make sure everything looked pretty good, adjusted all the strings, and then I went back and just piped a lot of glue to make sure that that mirror was stuck. And no need to add a loop for hanging, because you could actually hang it on the outermost ring of the form. Moving into project number three, I really wanted to create more of those decorative objects. I've been loving them for shelf spaces, and I'm using Rawhide Donuts in this project. And I do want to give a disclaimer that I had literally zero idea that these were made from animal products. I really did think that rawhide was like a man-made material that was just like rolled up into a shape, and it was just made of some random stuff. I don't even know, but it actually is made from animal products. So I just want to let you guys know that prior to sharing it with you, that way you are aware. And I'm also going to be using some black spray paint, wooden dowel, wooden base, drill, and a hot glue gun. So I took these little rawhide donuts from the dollar store, and I gave them a coat of Mod Podge. I just wanted to seal everything inside that was like in this rawhide donut. I don't even know what it is in it, but I'm just like painting it on there and just like sealing it in there. I didn't want it to have a smell or anything like that, and it actually had zero odor, zero smell at all. It just honestly smelled like nothing. And then once those were dry, I gave them a coating of black spray paint, but look at this little face I created with that circle. I thought it was funny. So I gave them a coating of this black matte spray paint. And the reason I picked these out at the store was that they were the most organic objects that I could find. I thought they were really, really great for a project like this. So I used a birch wood piece, and then I also used a drill, and I'm gonna drill halfway through this birch wood object. I've had this in my stash for a while. I got this at Joann's a long time ago. And I drilled about halfway through, and I used a wooden dowel as well. Used some hot glue inside of there, pushed the wooden dowel down, and then once your little donuts are dry, you can actually put these on the base. And you can also create these donuts from something like clay if you wanted to recreate this project. Just keep that in mind. And I glued these down onto the stick, and I actually glued them to each other. And I just wanted to create kind of this like three circle, almost sculpture look. So I glued these down using that Gorilla Glue hot glue, which is such a strong bond hot glue, keep in mind. And once they were completely dry, I placed them inside of a box and sprayed the entire thing like two full times with that black spray paint, just to make it look like one cohesive object. And in the end, I think it turned out like such a stunning piece of artwork. That was my video for today. I hope that you guys enjoyed those projects as much as I did. I absolutely love the outcome of each and every project, but I'm sure a lot of you have been kind of waiting for the giveaway. So let me just share with you super quickly what the rules are, what you're gonna be winning, and how to enter. So basically, I'm giving away one $250 Amazon gift card, but I'm also giving away five $50 Amazon gift cards. So there's a total of six different winners in this giveaway. So definitely enter if you'd like to, but let me tell you how exactly you can enter. I'm also gonna make sure to write all of the entry rules in the description box below if you want to take a look at that, just so you can see every single like rule kind of listed. It's super simple. It's open to everyone in the world, 100% international. The winner is going to be picked on January 1st via my community tab. So the first thing that you need to do to enter my giveaway is to be subscribed to my channel. So if you're not subscribed, click the subscribe button. And if you already are subscribed or you just subscribed, also make sure to click the bell icon next to the subscribe button and click turn on all notifications. That way you get notifications for my channel, and you also get notifications when I post the winner on my community tab. So make sure to click that bell icon, turn on my notifications. That is the first way to enter my giveaway. And then once you have done that, just leave a comment below letting me know that you are subscribed to my channel. So that is entry number one, but there are gonna be two additional ways to enter, which are totally optional. You don't have to do these, but if you do want two more chances to enter, you can definitely do so. So the first way is to follow me on Instagram at LoneFoxHome. I post really cute inspirational home images over there. I post behind the scenes stuff, so it's just a great place if you already like my channel. Definitely follow me on Instagram, LoneFoxHome. Once you have done that, leave an additional comment separate from your first one, saying that you follow me on Instagram, and that is your second way to enter. And the third way is kind of like the same way as the last. Just follow me on Instagram at I'm Drew Scott. That is my personal Instagram page. Once you have followed me on Instagram at I'm Drew Scott, you can leave a third comment separate from the first two. Make sure each comment entry is in a different one, because I'm going to be using a random generator at the end that pulls one comment. Leave a comment below letting me know that you followed me at I'm Drew Scott, and that is going to be your third way to enter. So it's super simple. There's three different ways to enter, so you have three possible chances of winning six different prizes. My camera literally just died, but thank you guys so much from the bottom of my heart for any of you who have subscribed to my channel, who have watched my content, who has commented on my content, left a thumbs up, bought a piece of merch, liked my Instagram photo. It is absolutely crazy what Lone Fox has come to over 2019. Like, I think we gained 300,000 subscribers. I started my Instagram, I launched my website, I launched my first line of merch. Like, absolutely insane, and it's all because of you. So I just want to thank you so much, and I wanted to give back to you, of course, for the holiday season. It is a time of giving, and I definitely thought that this giveaway was nice for any of you guys who might need an Amazon gift card. And I cannot wait to see what 2020 has to hold for us. I'm super excited. Like, Lone Fox is growing. This is so super fun. So thank you guys just for your love and support on my channel. And that is really all. I don't want to keep you for much longer. You probably have family and friends to go back to, but thank you for spending some time with me today, and I will catch you all in my next video. Have an amazing day. Bye, guys.